that I am here to present is elementary education of children and the role of non-governmental organizations. Now, as by far now we know what elementary education is, but why is it important? Elementary education is important because it provides a stable environment for the children to grow. It also paves way for further education. It helps in nation building and also reduces the rate of illiteracy and poverty. Initially, right to education was part of right to life. It is because education promotes a good and dignified life. And Article 21 itself has a widespread in itself. The question for the first time with regards to whether right to education is a fundamental right arose in the case of Mohini Jain versus State of Karnataka. And subsequently, it was discussed in the case of communication with the state of Andhra Pradesh, where it was held that elementary education shall be a fundamental right by which any child between the age group of 6 to 14 years of age shall be provided free elementary education. Despite the court's decision, no implementation programs or measures were taken. Therefore, the parliament felt the need to enact a Constitution 86 Amendment Act 2002. Which inserted Article 21A and the right to elementary education compulsory. Apart from this, right to education is also guaranteed by the guiding principles of state policies and also as a part of fundamental duty under 51A. In order to strengthen the legal framework further, the right of child to free and compulsory education in 2009 was enacted, and which was later amended in the year of 2019. The cross of this act is that a no detention policy up to class 8 has been initiated under section 16 of the act. And also 25% seats of the private schools were reserved for the weaker sections of the society. The amended act makes the no detention policy discretionary, that is at the will of the government itself. Now, legal framework without implementation program is meaningless. As we know, India is a vast country both geographically and demographically. Government alone cannot bring children into the course of education. This is where non-governmental organizations come into play, like Save the Children, Pratham, Smile Foundation, Cry, and many more. However, while ensuring that educational rights of children are protected, they are faced with a number of challenges, like their shortage of funds, lack of cooperation from families of children due to financial crisis. They prefer the children to earn than to learn. And there is a high rate of drop due to financial burden, as I said. Therefore, steps have been taken to combat challenges by projecting foreign and local funders for support, vocational training facilities, timely counseling of guardians, outreaching programs for controlling the rate of drop. Similarly, NGOs and Jayeta Ghosh also have been undertaking programs in order to provide education to children in the most systematic manner possible. And they try to cover up children belonging to all categories, including sex workers children, disabled children, and also transgender children. Their ultimate motto is to mainstream these children and provide them with a secure future. The slide here shows a child whose name is Amritkar. He suffers from obesity for several causes. And recently when I conducted a field survey and I visited the Brain Education Center, which is located in Salugara, I came across him. Firstly, to interact with children having disability, it takes you a little time to interact. But once they become comfortable with you, you learn that they have so much to teach us. That is why he loves math and aspires to become a math teacher. Also, when I asked him whether I can take a picture of him, he was very happy, and on showing him the picture, he replied with a thank you. But if we consider us, when we take a picture, we are never satisfied with the first picture that we take. We tend to click on more and more pictures. But these children, they are satisfied with the smallest things and they are happy with what they have. The second slide here shows a picture wherein of another organization called VASA, which is located in Shivmandi, Gurangia. The child who made this outfit is, her name is Prerna Bika. She is enrolled in Teresa School, Manitoba. I'm having a conversation with her. She is teaching that she aspires to become a fashion designer, and the outfit that is on is belly of this stitch and styled by her. Now we shall focus on the impact of the educational initiatives taken by the NGOs. We see that there is a decreasing rate of illiteracy. Since NGOs are outreaching families, counseling, there is a decreasing rate of illiteracy. Census of 2011 reveals that literacy rate in India has grown up to 8.14%, that is from 64.84% in 2001. There is a lower rate of dropouts, there is access to quality education, care competition, economic development. Lastly, I would like to conclude by saying that children are the future of this nation. Ensuring their education rights is everywhere, everybody's duty, because Parega India.